Hello, my name is Eric Rodriguez. I'm the student support specialist here at the University of Arizona, and today I'll be teaching you how to composite images in Photoshop using masks. So to get started, we're going to go ahead and take our second image, go ahead and drag it on top of the first. As you'll see, these guidelines will pop up, and what we're going to do now is resize our image to whatever size we want it to, and in this case we want it to make it seem as though this alligator here is popping up and attacking this guy on the skateboard. So I'd say about this is a good size. We're gonna go ahead and go up to the top here and click this check mark. Alright, so as you can see, this image doesn't exactly cover everything that we want to be covered. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the clone stamp tool and make the water extend all the way out to the edges right here. To do that, we're going to be using the clone stamp tool, which the keyboard shortcut for that is S. But first, we're going to go ahead and make sure that the image we want to edit is selected. So just over here on the side, we'll click on that. We'll go ahead and click S. As you'll see, there's this little kind of error that pops up. So what we're gonna do is hold option, and what this does is it selects the source for what we're going to be cloning. So in this case, we want the water right here, so we'll go ahead and select this area. So just option and click, and now we can go ahead and brush over here and extend the water. Now we'll go back and forth, just clone stamping, selecting new areas of the water to fill in. All right, now that that's finished, we're gonna go ahead and actually begin to remove areas of the image to just make this transition a little bit more seamless. So to start off, we're going to make sure that our crocodile layer is selected, and we're going to go down here and we're going to create a mask. All right, you'll notice that this white box has appeared next to your image, and what we're going to do now is use the brush tool. So go ahead and click B, and we're going to go ahead and obscure parts of the image that we don't want to be visible. So right away, you'll notice that your opacity and your flow are both at 100. And this isn't necessarily what we want, just because it'll be really rough around the edges. So we're going to go ahead and turn down our flow somewhere about 70%. And what this will do is it'll leave the edges a little softer, just so that our whatever we're cutting out won't be extremely clear cut and a little bit more natural. So you can use the left bracket and the right bracket keys on your keyboard to increase the size of your brush. And we're going to start off with a pretty larger brush. And if you notice off to the side here, there are two boxes. One is black and one is white. If they are any other color, you can go ahead and click D, and they'll switch over to black and white, since we will be using those for this instance. And you want to make sure that your black is selected, just because this is the option to obscure parts of the image, and white is the inverse of that, bringing parts of the image back. So we're going to go in and just remove all these parts of the image that we don't want to be in here. Since we're starting off with a larger size brush, it's okay to leave areas in between here. We don't really need to get too close, as we'll go back in later with a smaller brush and refine that. Now say for instance we mess up and we go a little too far in and erase parts that we didn't want to be erased. We can just go ahead and click X, and what that will do is switch over to white so we can bring parts of the image back. now that we've gotten rid of most of the edges using a larger brush, we're going to go ahead and size our brush down with the left bracket. And we're going to zoom in here, pinching with two fingers or scrolling on the mouse wheel. And we're going to get, oh, we're going to make sure we're still on black. And we're going to go in and add a little bit more detail and get a little closer to the image. And now that we've finished, your image should look something like this. Thank you for watching our tutorial. For more tutorial and content, head over to adobe.arizona.edu.